Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Vice President, Solid Edge Product Development, Dan Staples, and Applications Engineer, Siemens PLM Software, Craig Ruchti.
All right. Well, first of all, welcome to all of you. It's great to see all of you out there. I know many of the faces. I met some of you at the reception last night, and a lot of familiar faces in the crowd from years gone by. In my position, I have obviously a lot of businessy things to do, but two things I love to do best are to create software, work with my team, figure out what's next and how to create that thing, and to meet with you, our customers. So this is my highlight of my year in a lot of ways. So. Don't be shy on the breaks or at the receptions. Come up, introduce yourself. I'd love to meet each and every one of you to the extent that's possible. Today we want to share with you, Craig's going to help me here, the highlights of ST8. We don't have time to go through all of ST8 in detail, but that's what the breakout sessions are for. We're doing it a little different this year because obviously in the past what we've done is software was about to be released and we'd tease you with that software and then you'd go home and use your older version. Hopefully in this case, many of you have Solid Edge ST8 already. How many people out there are already using ST8? Okay, so quite a lot. It's only been out 4 months, so I appreciate that vote of confidence. I hope it's increasing your productivity as we expect it will. So we're gonna show you some highlights here, learn in the breakout sessions a lot more. So if we think about ST8 and kind of the big picture to start with, it's about designing without boundaries, as John said. We want to deliver a uniquely powerful portfolio. It's a 3D design portfolio, so it's not just CAD application, but a full portfolio of applications, wrapped up in an amazing user experience, and really that's what gives you this freedom to design without boundaries. If I tease out of that a couple of key points, kind of the three pillars of the release. First of all, uniquely powerful, we'll cover that in a lot of detail. Accessibility unleashed, I'll explain to you what do we mean by accessibility. It has a couple different dimensions to it. And finally, all wrapped up in that amazing user experience that we endeavor every day to bring to you in Solid Edge. So we want to start with something that is one of the features I really love in this release called, well, we call it internally, like me pattern recognition. We found that a lot of people are coming to us from other systems and they're bringing their data, and of course, traditionally that's dumb data. But there's no dumb data when you have synchronous technology. It all becomes smart data. So we've been working on a progression from recognizing holes to recognizing patterns of holes, patterns of patterns. The next thing in that progression is like me pattern recognition, where we can recognize patterns from random sets of geometry. So let's take a look at that here with Craig.
All right, thanks, Dan. So you guys having fun yet? Having a good time? All right, yeah, come on, let's have some fun. This is what this is about. So starting out, as you can see on screen, we have our armadillo robot that was so nice in one of the previous sessions gone through. And what we're going to be looking at today is basically the evolution of Solid Edge in patterning. So what we have here is an armature that has been designed for our armadillo. And what we want to do, or what we're going to do, rather, is we're going to show you that we need to change out the gripper arms on this particular armature. So we have these C-clamps currently located on it, and we've actually designed some additional armatures for this particular subassembly before. But the issue is that when it was saved off, it was actually saved off using a step file. Now, I'm sure most of you know what a step file is, but basically what that means is that whenever it was created or whenever it was saved, we have the 3D geometry available to us, but we don't have any kind of history or any of the features associated to it for the creation. So you'll notice that all it is a part copy inside of the synchronous environment. Of course, the great thing about synchronous technology in general is whenever you get ready to import any of your data into Solid Edge, it doesn't matter whether you have that history, it doesn't matter whether you have any of those features associated to it, because Solid Edge can very easily take that dumb solid or take that solid without any of these associated features and make it your own. So like me pattern recognition, all you have to do is go into our recognize patterns option, and you'll notice based on a face set selection, Solid Edge is automatically going to look at what you have available. You didn't have to tell it whether it was a circular pattern, whether it was a rectangular pattern. It's automatically going to see that. And check this out. It even shows you the suppressed instances of that pattern as well. So once we accept that in true Solid Edge fashion, now you have full control over this pattern. You have all that intelligence built in. We need to change this from 10 gears to 12 gears. And very quickly, we've taken something that would have taken quite a while to completely remodel, and we've made it our own. Of course, we don't just stop there with it. There's many different use cases for this great new tool, in the case that it doesn't have to be, you know, geometry that's on screen. We can also recognize cuts. It'll automatically pick up that rectangular pattern for us. You know what? We need to create a couple more teeth in this, make it a little bit finer for picking things up. We can very easily do that. I mean, just check that out. How long did that take me, Dan? How long do you think? Just a couple seconds, right?
15 seconds, yeah.
Exactly. And we've taken this dumb solid, and we've added all of this intelligence to it. Just simply save it off as a Solid Edge file. And then, of course, the final step in this is just quickly replacing our parts. And do that with the right one as well. And you can see in absolutely no time at all, we're able to take this previously designed part and put it into our subassembly to make it our own. So that's Lightning pattern recognition. Back to you, Dan.
All right, thanks, Craig. So you can see, I hope, why that's one of my favorite features. In Solid Edge, we always endeavor to make features where you don't have to do a lot of the work, we do the work for you. And the fact that you just pick the geometry, it will figure out, is it circular, is it rectangular, how many teeth are there? Are there missing teeth? It figures all that out for you. So great new thing in ST8. And what we see is more and more customers leveraging this technology to take those, what were traditionally called dumb solids, and make them smart. As I say, there's no dumb solids if you have synchronous technology. Great customer of Solid Edge, Philips Medical. They, a large company using Solid Edge and synchronous technology in particular. They buy different companies around the world, different subsidiaries to merge in. They're typically coming possibly from some other CAD system, ProE, SolidWorks, Inventor, something like that. So they have data from all these different sources, and they use Solid Edge synchronous technology as that glue. And it's these kind of things like the Like Me pattern recognition that lets them do that. The next area we want to talk about is synchronous technology in general. So what we find, again, we have people coming from other systems to Solid Edge, or we have people who are using Solid Edge ordered or history-based modeling and want to start learning synchronous technology. And invariably, people say, wow, that's super powerful. I want to get to know that. What we found in the past, though, is that the learning curve, the bump was just a little bit high for history-based users. It's a very different way of thinking, and it would come up with, you know, a lot of information to start with, and that information could possibly be a little confusing. Maybe you say, I got my day job to do, I'm back to ordered. So we've put a lot of effort in ST8 to make a very approachable heads-up UI for this, and we'll take a look at that with Craig. There we go.
Okay, so the name of the game here is design intent. I'm sure all of you know what design intent, but what design intent is, but for those of you who might not, it's basically a designer's intentions whenever he creates his parts or whenever he puts things together through relationships, through how it's built to make sure that things update properly and things move the way that they're supposed to. Now, Solid Edge takes that step out. Of course, if a designer wants to build in his own design intent, he easily can do that. However, in ST8, we've made that just so much simpler for you guys to understand, for our customers to be able to grasp the full concept of what's happening inside of synchronous technology. And you'll notice that as we get ready to make any kind of synchronous move, Solid Edge is recognizing all of the design intent that is available to you during that move. So Solid Edge in synchronous technology is basically saying, hey, we have symmetry, and you'll notice whenever you mouse over this, it's an interactive experience. It's going to highlight the faces that are symmetric, and we also have a coplanar face. That's what it recognizes inside of this model. So if we want to ever change that design intent, we easily can do that. As I said before, it's an interactive experience to where you can test this out as you move along. And if you're just learning synchronous, as Dan was saying, you know, getting into that learning curve, there's so many great tools to help you through this. You'll notice that, you know, we have this context-sensitive help that's going to basically allow us to see what all of this means. If in any situation, you want to learn even more, we can. We have these great videos associated to these commands to where it'll walk you through, it'll show you how everything's coming together. So utilize those tools because they're very powerful and they'll help you a lot in the process of creating your designs. For this particular move, we want to change our design intent. It allows us to change our design intent on the fly. We don't want to maintain that coplanar face because basically what we're doing here is we're working on version 2.0 of our interface adapter for our armadillo robot. Now, I'm sure if you've worked inside of Synchronous, you know just how simple it is to sketch and not have to worry about consuming full sketches, things of that nature. It's very easy to get geometry on screen. So do a quick round there to make sure nobody cuts themselves on the edges. But for our next move, we want to do a rotate on this side face. Now what you see on this little dialogue here is basically all of the defaulted design intent relationships that Solid Edge is going to pick up in your moves. Another great thing about this, if you're more of a power user, if you're in this every single day and you work with Synchronous, you know all about Synchronous, of course we're going to have all of our hotkeys still associated to all of these relationships, but we also are going to automatically allow you to pin this in another location. If you don't want that dialog coming up next to your pointer, it's very easy to move that out of the way for usability, and therefore you'll be able to utilize your hotkeys. Now as I begin this rotate on this outside face, you'll notice that we're going to pick up symmetry in our design intent recognition, but we actually want to take this a step further. We know that top step over the top of the face we're rotating, we want that to move along with it, but we just want to go ahead and knock it out without doing two separate moves. We can easily go into our advanced option. You'll see on the design intent dialog box that we have advanced. I'm just going to use the V key because it makes it a lot easier to use the hotkeys, and then we can pick up our parallel faces, which is going to be a hotkey of L, but Solid Edge is automatically going to recognize that top step is going to be parallel to the bottom step and allow us to make our change all at one time. So Solid Edge gives you so much power and to be able to control these designs exactly how you want to. And that's kind of key because what your expectations are for these designs is what Solid Edge and Synchronous Technology are going to try to offer you. So what is the logical solution for if I grab a piece of geometry and I want to go and pull it out? Simply pull it out. You know, that's exactly what you're expecting to happen whenever you create something like this. And that's what Solid Edge is going to offer to you. Okay, for this next thing that we're going to be taking a look at, this is actually, it might be a bit trivial to some of you guys, but it's actually one of my absolute favorite new enhancements in Solid Edge ST8, just because I didn't realize I needed it until I got it. And then it was like, wow, this is fantastic. And it's, when you used to make a symmetric line, you used to have to, you know, that was a multi-step process any way you looked at it. Solid Edge ST8, not anymore. Just simply hit your S key for symmetry. It's automatically going to drag that line out for you and allow you to make that symmetrical about the midpoint. But even better than that is the intelligence that Solid Edge and Synchronous Technology brings alongside with it. So we're just going to associate these holes real quick to the outside of this line. And those of you who work with Synchronous and know about Synchronous know that sketches, other than getting geometry on screen, don't really mean a whole lot to us. But since that line was symmetric, what do you think is going to happen to these holes that were associated to the endpoints? They're going to maintain that symmetry as well. So just intelligence in your design to be able to recognize that design intent for you, bring it apart, allow you to change your intent on the fly. If we don't want to keep these aligned holes, we just turn off aligned holes. It's as easy as that. And then, of course, you can't really show a demonstration showing Synchronous and the power of it without doing some kind of drastic change that just shows you the true power of being able to capture exactly what you want and be able to change your design intent on the fly. So, you know, for our interface 2.0 adapter, we want to be able to rotate all of this geometry so that it connects differently. Just very easy, very fantastic new capability in Solid Edge ST8 to walk you through all these capabilities. So, man, that's design intent. Back to you, Dan.
All right. Thanks, Craig. I think one of the great things about Synchronous Technology, it kind of ties into what Philip was saying earlier this morning, and I was talking with folks last night about it. You know, design is not a linear process. I think he called it the elephants in the mist, right? You see things at a distance. You often have blind alleys. You need to make corrections, and you need the flexibility to do that, and that's why the people who are using Synchronous are finding it so productive, because design isn't a linear process, and you can adapt things very easily. We did, however, feel like we needed to bring it to you in an interface that's easier, more approachable, and the feedback around that has been excellent, particularly many of you out there already using ST8. Next thing we want to talk about, patterns again. Patterns happen a lot in mechanical parts, and that's pattern by table. So we, of course, have had pattern of holes, circular, rectangular, pattern along curve. Here we're talking about being able to drive it from an Excel spreadsheet, and being able to do it that way provides you a whole new level of flexibility. Let's take a look at that here with Craig.
All right, fantastic. So pattern by table. We've seen the evolution of patterning recognition when it comes to Lightning pattern recognition. Now let's take a look at the true strength and the power that Solid Edge has when it comes to patterning. Now we have a controller that we're going to use to control our robot. And we've created a previous version of this, and we just want to reuse the exact same button pad, but we need to make some changes to it. Now the button pad that you see on screen is actually being controlled through an Excel spreadsheet, through a table. And we need to match up our cuts to the button pad itself. So step one is just obviously select the geometry that we want. And then there's the new option inside of Solid Edge ST8 called pattern by table. Of course, one of my absolute favorite aspects of working in Solid Edge, and I've worked in several different CAD systems, is the fact that anytime you enter a new command, I'm not sure if you guys can see this very well from the crowd out there, but you're always going to have a status. You're always going to have instruction on where you need to go with this. You're never going to be stuck wondering what the next step is. So for our next step, we need to select a coordinate system. And then we also have the option of where we want to reference this pattern from. I'm just going to do it from the center of our reference sketch here. And then all we have to do is browse out and bring in our Excel spreadsheet that is going to update this for us. And you can see, I mean, just how quick we were able to bring in that pattern, bring in those cuts. You know, this is a very atypical pattern, and you can imagine what kind of complexity that you can bring in with this kind of capability. So, of course, this is our version one of our number pad, and we need to make some changes to this. So let me show you how we interact with Excel to be able to accommodate for this. For our design, we want to get rid of all of these middle rows here. So guess how you do that inside of Excel? You just select the buttons that you don't want there, and you simply delete them. It's pretty intuitive, right? It's pretty easy to understand that concept. Now we need to add a little stylized design to the middle here. We want to move the middle two down 11 millimeters and the bottom two up 11 millimeters. So down 11 millimeters, up 11 millimeters, down 11 millimeters, and so on. Of course, being able to save and seeing the live update as we go, it's going to allow us to keep track of where we're at inside of our Excel spreadsheet, make sure we're getting the results that we're looking for. We need to change the angles on the top two. Of course, the third column is nothing but angles, so we want to go from negative 20 degrees to positive 20 degrees, positive 20 degrees to negative 20 degrees, and then we're going to see that we get the results that we're looking for. So all of this being powered through an Excel spreadsheet, and for our last change, we want to add another button, so guess how we do that? Adding another button is as easy as inserting another row in our spreadsheet. We want it to go directly in the middle of all of these things. So directly in the middle of 0 and 126 would be what? Anybody? 63. Beautiful. Yes, the media people didn't know that much about that, strangely enough. All right, so halfway in between 0 and negative 66. Ah, beautiful. Thank you guys so much. It's so much easier when I don't have to think about these things. All right, so, and we don't want any angle on it. We just want it to be straight to match up with everything else. Check this out. We got a very complex, atypical pattern that was formed simply through controlling values on an Excel spreadsheet. I mean, you can think of the power that's associated to this. You want to know the best part? Is our previous version of this number pad. All it has to do is go out, read those values back in from that Excel spreadsheet, and now we have multiple parts being driven through that one spreadsheet, and that's some pretty powerful stuff. Pattern by table, Solid Edge ST8, great new capability.
Very nice. Thank you, Craig.
Thank you. Come on, guys. Yeah.
So I think you got a good flavor for it there. There's certain features that I'm always amazed by how our users use them and what they do with them. This one, I guarantee I'm going to see all sorts of interesting usage. So if you think about the flexibility of Excel, you can have very complicated formulas. You can have lookup tables. You can make a call to a database and get answers for where your pattern occurrences come. I expect everybody in this audience is going to come up with some unique and interesting way to use it, and I look forward to talking to you next year about that.
The more that we think about this, we've made some changes. We've changed the complexity. We've changed the layout of our controller. How are our users going to know, you know, how to use it now? We've changed the buttons around. You know, is there a way that we can take the design changes that we've made and actually give them something tangible, something usable to be able to learn it?
Well, it's funny that you should ask that because there's an app for that. And to tell us about that app, I would like to spill some water on the stage, hopefully not short everything out. That's not my water, by the way. And welcome on stage, Brian Roberts, president of Quadraspace. Brian,
thank you.
Welcome.
Thank you, guys. All right, well, I'm here to talk about Quadraspace. And Quadraspace is a technical publishing solution for Solid Edge users. It'll let you take your 3D model and use that to create manufacturing instructions or illustrated parts catalogs, product manuals, those kind of things. You can create both printed and interactive content with our software. And I got three products to show you here, so if we can roll the video, we can get started then. It's on here, but there we go. All right, the first step is to use our freely available Solid Edge add-in to export directly from the CAD software to a lightweight format. Now this format's a single file, so you can share it with other people. Your engineers don't have to be involved with that. They can export the file and give it on to somebody else and get back to engineering. We have a pretty robust integration with Solid Edge, so we support a lot of the features that you might find in Solid Edge. And once you have your Solid Edge file exported, you can use our first product, Publisher 3D, to create these technical illustrations. In our initial example, we'll create a set of illustrations for a manual. We're going to use that same controller that Craig was using. And we're also going to use the robot as well in a second. But while this is a simple example, it shows how engineers and non-engineers alike can use a different product to create the manuals and the product information. It's full of 3D features, callouts, balloons, all kinds of things you need for creating your documentation. Now, we also exported the armadillo model, and we're going to use that to create exploded views. Now, if you've created your exploded views in Solid Edge already, you can use those instead. So you can choose to use Quadraspace or Solid Edge for creating the exploded views. So now that we have a nice set of illustrations, it's easy to publish these as either raster or vector graphics. In this case, we're going to do vector graphics. Vector graphics are the line drawings with nice crisp edges. And we're going to save these as SVG files. And the SVG files is a standard so that if you're already using tools like Adobe Illustrator, then these files can be picked up in those as well. And you'll be able to maintain the same process that you're already using in other departments. So Publisher 3D is also a great tool for creating interactive content, animated content. In this example, you'll see that we're using a thing called smart template technology to take your exploded view and automatically generate a set of illustrations. You'll see those bubble up along the bottom there as they automatically generate. And you can see how this, what it does is it hides and it shows the different parts so that you don't have to go manually create each step of the process, and then you can quickly create an animation from an exploded view. You'll see how the parts are showing up as you go. You can also add descriptions to each of the illustrations. And down at the bottom, you can see how it's adding a description to that last final step. So once we're done with these instructions, they can be published to PDF or to the web. And this is an example on a web page here on our Share3D site. We'll talk about that in just a moment. However, there might be a better choice for creating interactive content, and that'd be with our Pages 3D product. This is our flagship product, and it takes technical documentation to the next level. It combines 3D with your page layout, so you can create a document that has 3D in it, tables, text, imagery, all in a single place there. You can get started by picking one of our 50 templates. You just basically go through and pick a template. You might have your own template that you make as well, or you can start from a blank page, and then you pick your model. And once you have that, it'll automatically generate a draft version of your document. You can go through and edit the viewpoints, edit the text. It has an interface a lot like Microsoft Office or something, so it's really simple to set up these documents. They're multiple page. You can put as many models in them as you need in order to get your information out there. The viewpoints can be selected, or you can create them on the fly. It has the same 3D capabilities as the other product, too, so if you learn one, you can work with the other. Another thing about pages is there's the ability to use page templates, and you can quickly use a page template and repeat. You'll push through, like that instruction set we made earlier, you can push that through, and it will automatically make a bunch of print-ready pages where it has the graphic and the text below it, so you can see how, in this example, looking through a few pages, it has the different content ready to go. It's also easy to create illustrated part catalogs where you can match the parts list with the view. So as I pull off those balloons, you'll see that they're matched up automatically with the view, the graphics. So when it's complete, we can print. Or in this case, we create a static PDF, same thing as a print, basically. And you can see this is in Adobe Reader. And it's not interactive at this point. We'll talk about one of the interactive in a second, but you can see the thumbnails on the side and all the pages of our manual were printed. Now, it's an especially powerful application for creating interactive documentation. So generally, an interactive document will use a different template. This is a template choice here that's more of a interactive work instruction. And you can see that it's just as easy to edit here. You just drag out your components. In this case, we drag out a table that you click on the table and it highlights the part in the scene and vice versa. So when you publish it to a PDF, the PDF documents, when they're interactive, can also include all of this information. A lot of people don't know, but Adobe Reader itself, without any plugins, can support 3D. So in this case, this is just a regular old PDF document. You can click on buttons, you can rotate, pan, and zoom your model, and you can send that out into a ubiquitous delivery format. So this time, one of our new things coming up is the ability to take these multiple page documents and publish them to the web. And in this example, you'll see the same document we just had, but now it's on an HTML5 output. And pretty much anybody can view this. It doesn't really matter what device. It's supported on whatever operating system that you're working with. So that's the nice thing about the HTML5. It's pretty ubiquitous as well. So the final solution that I want to talk about today is our Share3D cloud solution. It allows you to take these manuals and put them online. So you've already seen how Quadrispace products are used to create these instruction sets, to create these technical documents. But what Share3D allows you to do is not just deliver to print and PDF, but it opens up a whole door to the web where you can very easily just upload that to the web and then share that. You can either share it. Well, when you share it, it's an HTML5, like I mentioned before, which pretty much Mac, PC, Android, iOS, whatever browser you want to look at it, it all supports it. It's a pretty pretty cool new development in the underlying technology. And with cloud solutions, you do get the benefit of collaboration features because it's out there for everybody to share. And for our collaboration, we have a commenting system and an online shopping cart that you can hook up. And finally, the Share3D service allows you to maintain or manage whatever files you put up. So you can either make those password protected, you can require a login from specific emails, or you can make them wide open. You can share a URL, or you can embed a URL, or you can embed it into your own website so you can cover it with your own graphics. So that's pretty much our set of solutions. If we can go back to the slideshow now. 1B? Okay. All right, so, well, now that you see what our solutions are, I just would like to invite you to come. We have a booth in the Partner Center over here. My mouth's getting dry. And I'd invite you to come in and talk to me. There's also a session, Design Fusions hosting a session in room 236 at 1:30. They're doing an intro to Pages 3D, I'd invite you to go check that out too. You'll learn a lot more and have about an hour to work with it instead of just 10 minutes. Thank you.
Thanks a bunch. Thank you, Brian. Very impressive product. I first saw that product a couple years back, and I was like, wow, this is a wonderful set of solutions and very well priced. It very much fits the Solid Edge customer base, and very excited to have them as a partner with an excellent plug-in for Solid Edge. Next up, we want to talk about welding. So Solid Edge has always had a very extensive welding system, fillet welds, groove welds. We've spent a lot of time working on that and making it deeper and more robust, working with many of our larger customers who have a lot of weldments. But it's always been in the context of the assembly. So the assembly holds the welds. Most assemblies are custom welded, and that works quite well. But we've also thought about putting it into part. If we put welds into part, there are some distinct advantages of that. And so with ST8, you can choose between having your welds in your assembly or having your welds in the part file. And we'll see a little bit of that with Craig right now.
All right, thanks, Dan. So let's set the stage a little bit here. We have our robot, but we needed to create a work stand to be able to assemble it, to be able to do work on it and things of that nature. For our stand, we actually have some bracketry that needs to have some welds associated to it. Of course, as Dan was saying, there are quite a few advantages to being able to push welding down into the part. The first being that you're going to be able to define whatever type of material that you want to use for your weld. So we're just going to go ahead and quickly create our own part. Of course, all you really need to create welds inside of parts is access to the geometry you're going to weld. And that's the beauty of Solid Edge, is you always have access to everything whenever you go down into the part, right? So all we need to do is click on our new fillet weld inside of the part, and then you just simply select the geometry in which you want to weld together. It's automatically going to give you a nice preview and very quickly place those welds where you need it. Of course, the true beauty of this entire thing is that as you're moving through and as you're working on these welds, there are so many other options available to you as far as how you're going to be able to have control not only of the physical properties of these welds, so you don't have to worry about them being assembly features or anything like that. You're going to be able to have full access to the physical properties. You're going to be able to use any of our sketching techniques to be able to create custom cross sections, whatever the case may be, and it's a very, very powerful capability to be able to push these welds down into the part. Now, I could easily go through and select all those other aspects of these brackets to be able to push this weld out all the way across, but I'm going to use a different command for that. So how many of you guys were paying attention in Solid Edge ST7 updates when we introduced a very cool capability called duplicate component? You guys remember that one? Thank you, Dan. So check this out. Now that we have all of our welds located in a single part file, we can easily select that weld part. And then I want everybody to watch very carefully. Don't blink if you didn't get to see this in ST7. Check this out. We just select the geometry that our part is associated to, and then we find all matching occurrences. And notice how it pushes those welds to every single additional bracket on top of that. So very quickly, we can put those welds exactly where we want them, just a couple of clicks, and we're through it. So, of course, as you take this into draft, there's a lot of additional capability, being able to estimate costing through your physical properties, things of that nature that allow it to be a very powerful new capability in Solid Edge ST8. So welding, Solid Edge ST8. Back to you, Dan.
All right. Thank you, Craig. Yeah, really happy with that particular set of functionality in welding. We have a lot of customers who do weldments, literally sometimes hundreds of pounds of weld in a given assembly. And the ability to use the duplicate command, which, as Craig said, he's leveraging, awesome. As well as one of the things that we've had in the past is several requests for people who bend up sheet metal parts, and you bend up a box and you just want to weld the corners. You don't have to go into assembly to do that right in part, or even draw your own weld. Use any of the part modeling commands you might like and simply tag it as a weld, and it'll fly through the process the rest of the way in draft and so on. Next area we want to talk about is enriched digital mockup. So one of the things that I encourage you all to do is make use of the assets you have. So with Solid Edge, you're super productive in creating 3D models, 3D assemblies. And we just saw a second ago with Brian that you can use those digital assets for downstream purposes. We can create technical documentation with them. We also find that a lot of our customers want to put their assemblies into motion, that they want to be able to show their customers how these assemblies work. And so with Enriched Digital Mockup, we've added to our already impressive arsenal of tools in doing that. So let's take a look at that with Craig.
All right, so Enriched Digital Mockup. That's a good one. That's basically referring to a whole bunch of different capabilities in ST8 that they've been added in so that you can get realistic motion out of the designs that you create, out of your assemblies. We're going to focus on a few key areas here that are basically going to allow you to put these things in motion. Now, the new enhancement for ST8 that we're going to be taking a look at is actually called Variable Table Motor. And Variable Table Motor basically allows you to drive any of your variables from your assembly in a motor to be able to show motion. Now, what are variables, you might ask? Variables are going to be any relationships that you have associated, anything like that. So we actually have a path relationship associated to our tread for our armadillo. And we also have a drive wheel. So our drive wheel is going to be represented by this wheel down here, and we want to make sure that as that drive wheel turns, the path on the tread turns as well, so everything's associated to one another. All we need to do in order to do that is just set our variables equal to one another. So we want our drive wheel or our drive belt to follow our drive wheel. Just like Excel, you enter in a formula. Notice that our red tread, which is our master occurrence on our pattern, automatically updates so that everything is aligned. And then the new capability in Solid Edge ST8, just add a variable table motor. Variable table motor is going to allow you to access any of these variables inside of the variable table, and then it's going to allow you to set up your speed. It's going to allow you to set up the actual motor aspects of it within the dialog. Now, in addition to that, when you focus on these two arms up here, there's something, you know, we're not going to set up another motor, but I want to just point something out to you that's a very powerful new capability in ST8 as well. And that is the fact, actually, let's start this off a little bit different. How many of you guys were paying attention in ST7 when you saw that when you dove down into subassemblies for adjustable subassemblies, you had access to all of the relationships associated to that subassembly? You guys remember that? So you could see how the subassemblies were reacting, even if you're in a top level? Well, check this out. New to Solid Edge ST8, we've taken that just another step further. Now we can actually override relationships inside of the subassembly and push those up to the top-level assembly. So remember I said relationships are linked to variables. So now we have a variable from a subassembly in our top-level assembly. Guess what we can do with that? We can control it through a motor, right? I mean, just very, very powerful capability involved with that. At this point, all we need to do is go ahead and bring in our motors from our variable table motors. And you'll also notice that we have several new capabilities that just really enhance the experience of working in the playback environment. So, you know, we have the tried and true copy and mirror so that we get the reverse motion on the animation timeline here. We also have a fit to, which is one of my favorite. If any of your timeline events are going beyond the extent of it, you can suck that back in. But basically what you're looking for is being able to see that realistic update whenever you start moving. And now you'll notice on screen, it's not moving as quickly as you know, realistic time would have, but there's a lot of calculation taking place in that. You know, there's a lot of patterns updating. There's a lot of things moving in conjunction with one another. But that's why we've also enhanced the way that you can save these videos out. We now support WMV. So, you know, a little bit more compressed, a little bit easier to work with, things like that. And if you look real closely, how many of you guys also remember back a release or two ago when we incorporated KeyShot directly into Solid Edge? Not only can we send the images out to be rendered, but we can also send out our animation timeline. We can send out our animations to be rendered as well. And what we're looking for in the end is a beautiful rendered video like what you see right up here, fully capable of being produced inside of Solid Edge and then sent out to be rendered in KeyShot. So just some great new enhancements for Enriched Digital Mockup inside of Solid Edge ST8. Dan? Yeah.
Yeah, really kudos to the product planning and product management team on this and the assembly team as well, many of whom are here in the audience. This is one of those things where we did did many, many little things that all together create a big thing. Being able to, for example, when you change that variable, it's pushing all the way down, solving everything, including the patterns and so on, overriding the relationships at the top level assembly, and then also just being able to not have to set up a motor. You just say, well, this variable, I want to drive it at this rate for this time.
Dan, I was also thinking about this, and you know, we have some great realistic motion that we can now represent inside of Solid Edge. We've set up all of our motors, we set up all of our animations and things of that nature. But what happens when we actually want to actually test the entire thing out? You know, if we want to see what kind of power is required through the servos, if we want to actually be able to run some kind of motion simulation, I mean, is that possible inside of Solid Edge?
Well, it's kind of funny you should ask that, because there's an app for that. And to introduce us to that app, let me welcome on stage Scott from with the Dynamic Designer product. Scott, welcome.
Thanks, Dan. Right. Welcome, everybody. My name is Scott. I'm with Design Simulation Technologies. And I'd like to dovetail a little bit on what Craig was talking about with the digital mock-up. That's some great stuff. But there is that underlying question as to how it's going to function physically against a physical prototype. We can see some nice animations with that product, but you know, what do we do when we want to test how it's going to perform before we cut any metal or create any parts, right? So let's take a look at a short video here of a product called Dynamic Designer. Dynamic Designer is functional design validation inside of Solid Edge. It allows you to understand the physics behind your model before you cut any metal or make any parts. Thank you, by the way, to Ross for the nice model as well. We're fully embedded inside of Solid Edge, so that means that the workflow is very quick, and we retain the model associativity to the Solid Edge data, such as mass properties, geometry, and things like that. All that information propagates to the Dynamic Designer model. It's easy to create multiple mechanisms and do multiple studies if you're trying to find out what's going on with different design scenarios and situations. Here we can see we're automatically transferring the assembly constraints from the design, from the Solid Edge assembly into Dynamic Designer. We also have a whole array of joints that you can create inside of Dynamic Designer if there's not an assembly constraint that suits your needs for a particular a motion of a joint or a model. And here we can see that we're making a change. We desire to change a particular constraint. It's just a matter of going back to the Solid Edge assembly, changing that constraint type, and then coming back into Dynamic Designer and having it update automatically. As you'll see here, we change something from what's called a spherical joint to a revolute joint, and we get that recognition automatically. Mass properties, geometry changes, all propagate to the Dynamic Designer model, makes it very easy for workflow. Simulating real-world physics, real-world things in here, collisions, friction, energy, momentum, those types of things, comes naturally with the product. We recall in college how many calculations we had to do by hand. Well, that's what software is for, okay? All those calculations and that technology is put into software to help you understand that. Without having to be an expert engineer. So creating different motions and things like that. Here you see we're importing test data from, say, a physical test, and we're bringing that in to drive the model with physical test data. That's a great method for correlation of a physical model against a virtual prototype. And now once you have those two correlated, you can understand how it's going to be much less costly to make changes to the virtual model than it is to the physical model. Running through different scenarios, such as making geometry changes, leveraging the patterns and the Excel spreadsheet that Craig was talking about, makes it easy to update your assembly and look at different scenarios. Some of the post-processing in here is very friendly, very easy to use, drag and drop. What if we want to look at different forces or torque or energy, velocities, accelerations on different joints? It allows you to create multiple plots. We can export that data to CSV files for further post-processing. And the plot functionality in here is very similar to Excel in what you do in terms of changing the properties of the plots and things like that. And what you're going to see here is we're able to preserve the data from one run and then start a new simulation after we make a change. And in this particular example, we're making a change to the friction for one of the joints you can see highlighted there at the top. So simply changing a friction coefficient, and then, or before it didn't have friction, now we're adding friction to it, rerunning the simulation, and now we've got a comparison of new against against old data. Can you imagine how long that would have taken to have done by hand? Okay, I can recall what that was in college, and it wasn't fun. There's other features in here for visualizing what that numerical data is or what the graphical data is. We call those graphical vectors. Here we're seeing adding graphical vectors to one of the members right here. And we can see that those red arrows are the normal force reactions and the blue arrows are the moments. This is going to show a very nice feature we've got coming up here in terms of what loads we might need to know for a solid edge simulation. We can preserve this data just like we talked about before and make those runs. So those vectors scale and they show us what's happening with the model. If anybody remembers the phrase free body diagram, this is a great tool for that. Helps you understand what's taking place at each of the reactions. And this feature you're looking at now is called a trace path. We can trace out the path of any profile or any the movement or path of trajectory that an object moves through. And what's more is we can bring that data back in to a model where we can send it out as a CSV. And we can do different things like reverse engineer a cam profile, not even knowing what the profile looks like, maybe just the follower movement. So some nice capability there. And you can see, too, that once the animation or the simulation is done, we can easily create animations and drop off AVI movie files. Here's the nice feature that we've got in here now. It came a couple years ago. We transfer loads automatically to a solid edge simulation. Loads from loads for a FEA can be difficult to calculate, especially when you've got a model with dynamics involved. Loads from motions are difficult to calculate because you've got inertia that has a factor in there. Sometimes the maximum load is not necessarily the worst case load. You could have different, one joint is in high force, another is in high moment, so you might need to look at different scenarios of the design here and pinpoint which is the worst. Here, what we've done is we've created a solid edge simulation study, and we've defined the part we're interested in looking at in the study, and then we've just added those reaction force vectors. So now we can get a visual of what to expect in the solid edge simulation study. And now we've added the vectors, and we're going to transfer those loads to the solid edge simulation study after we position it to one of our potential worst case scenarios. And you can see that those loads are automatically added as visual graphics inside of Dynamic Designer. And once we toggle over into solid edge simulation, we can see that the loads populate the list there in just a moment when we expand the force list. Okay. It includes gravity, any forces due to inertia, and things like that. Maybe you have to add an additional restraint in there and then solve the simulation after that. But the idea is it takes that big chunk of guesswork out of obtaining those loads for the simulation. And in a moment here, we can see a final result. And there it is. So we've got, we've basically got an idea of what's going on with that part in that load scenario. Very easy to go back, look at a different load scenario, and transfer the loads again. Okay? So I invite you guys to come visit us. If you think that motion simulation might be a fit for you, I'd be happy to answer any questions you might have. Thanks, Craig.
Thank you. Yeah.
Thank you, Scott. Thank you, Scott. Another great example of some of the awesome applications that you'll find in the Solid Edge ecosystem. Particularly like that because it's a it's type of application that really requires that kind of in-window integration. It's great to see the work Dynamic Designer's done over a period of years, both in terms of reading the assembly constraints automatically and then tying it to solid edge simulation on the back end. So it's really a full soup to nuts process.
That's awesome.
Next area I want to talk about is enhanced drawings. So Solid Edge, we're the drawing creation guys. I think you can talk to a lot of folks in industry, and I hope everybody in this room that sees us as the drawing creation guys. We have some great tools for creating 3D PMI, and we have some great tools for taking those out to JT files and a variety of leading edge things. The fact of the matter is that the people in this room still create drawings, and will be creating drawings for a very long time. And when I talk to my users, what they say is, you've made productive, solid modeling and assemblies, and the thing that takes me the most time, and I hate doing the most, is creating the drawings, but I have to do it. So we want to take that and take that number as small, as close to zero as possible, the amount of time it takes to create the drawings. And so ST8 is no exception there. We continue to invest heavily in that. Let's take a look at that with Craig.
All right, beautiful. Thanks, Dan. So as Dan was saying, ST8 drawings are all about improving our usability to our customers, making sure that they get the results that they're looking for, and cutting down greatly on the amount of time that they spend in time the drawing inside of the drawing environment to get the proper results. Now, you'll notice as we move through all these different dimensions, there are new dimension handles in ST8 that are going to allow you to update your drawings however you want to, update your dimensions, get the proper visualization from doing so. And it's also logical representation of what you would expect to happen. You got some stacked dimensions. They all share these dimension lines, these extension lines. It's going to show that for every single one of them. Additionally, we've added a couple more really nice little capabilities in there. You'll notice that, well, prior to ST8, if you wanted to move your terminators, you wanted to flip them, it was quite easy because all you had to do was grab them and flip them over. We still have that full capability. But check this out. We now have this wonderful little dialogue that's going to come up anytime you're working inside of a draft environment. It's going to allow you to have full control over your terminators. We want to change over to dots for our terminators. We don't have to worry about going through any, you know, properties, anything like that, going into any complex dialogues. Additionally, if you have something that's, you know, running into another dimension, you need to figure out what you want to do with your dimension lines. Simply turn them off. Why not, right? So it gives you full control over every individual dimension that you have on screen. If you ever want to turn that dimension line back on, guess what? Solid Edge is going to look after that for you as well. You're always going to be able to access that, always going to be able to control that. Now, of course, if we're going to do that with dimensions, we sure got to do it with annotations, right? So finish symbols, same capabilities as far as being able to have full control over them. Another really neat thing is, let's just add a little break here. You'll notice that as you're moving your dimension lines, or whatever the case may be, your extension lines, it's going to give you snap 2 points for every 15 degrees to make sure you get those proper angles, make sure that everything looks right whenever you're creating them. Of course, that leads into another one of my absolute favorite new capabilities in Solid Edge ST8, and that I don't spend a ton of time inside of the draft environment, inside of drawings. So whenever it came time to format the syntaxing of your format codes, you know, you want to change the way that you're displaying your units, say. We want dual units. Solid Edge ST8, check this out. It's got a new dialogue that's going to allow you to go through that. You want to be able to change to a round-off error of 4 digits. I mean, check that out. Check out how easy that is. You don't have to remember any of this syntaxing. You don't have to remember any of that format code. It's automatically going to be there with you. And taking that one step forward, you know, some more complex formatting. We want to have a stack tolerance in here between 0.002 and 0.005, which is not easy to say one way and type the other. I had to practice that once or twice. But, you know, it makes it very easy for you to be able to basically format however you want to. I mean, look at all the different possibilities for date and time. Let's go ahead and make it all uppercase while we're at it, just to make sure that everything's consistent. Takes no time at all. Solid Edge is going to look after it. It's going to make it easy for you. Like Dan was saying, spend as little time as possible inside of the drawing environment so that you can get these drawings out the door. Next thing we're going to take a look at is basically going to be a continuation of Solid Edge and its investment in looking after your drawings. So how many of you guys remember inside of Solid Edge ST7, we created the capability, if you have a datum referenced inside of a callout, you update that callout, it's automatically going to update in the datum. You guys remember that one? All right, check this out. We're going to do the same thing with reference texting. Rather than having to hand jam in, you know, if you want to refer to that datum, we can easily go and reference the exact same type of thing and push that datum down into that reference text. Any changes happen on the top level on that datum itself, It's going to update not only in your callouts, but in your reference texting as well. Along the exact same lines, how many of you guys know what technical requirements are? Nobody? All right. I'll wait. I got no problems. I can sit up here. Basically, these are the instructions that you want to send to the manufacturer whenever you send your drawings out. You want to make sure that whenever you send these instructions out that your parts are getting produced properly. So these are things like check all your dimensions, stamp part number here. And these are things that are very important, like all ST8 SEU attendees must learn how to type because I can't. Must upgrade immediately. So these are things that you don't take lightly whenever you see them on these requirements, right? However, Solid Edge is going to allow its users, I went a little long-winded on that second one, to automatically link these. If you come to a callout and you want to check your requirement, rather than just hand jamming in a number, say we want to check requirement two, or we want to look at requirement two, we can now go and actually reference any of those technical requirements. You know, we want to stamp our part number in the middle of our part here. We're going to be able to do that for you. And now you say, well, Craig, that was an extra step. Why wouldn't I just put in the number two? What happens if your technical requirements, you know, the more important ones end up moving up in the list, things end up getting a little switched around? Solid Edge is automatically going to look after that for you. So just another step in the evolution of making sure that you are getting the proper results from your drawings when you send them out. You're not going to have to look after all this stuff yourself. We're going to do that for you. So some of the great enhancements in ST8 for drawing.
Awesome. Well, I'm going to applaud that one. There are literally so many things in drafting and drawing in ST8 that we can't list them all. We can only show you a little bit. I encourage you to go to the sessions and see more. Some of my favorites are the new format values. That's been a longstanding pet peeve of mine that, you know, you do have to know those secret codes, and you got your secret decoder ring, and, you know, people in the audience spend their whole life figuring those out. Well, now it's all just in a pull-down list. It's super easy. And I really do like the progression here that we've had with the datums associativity, the technical requirements test. These are things where, you know, you're having to pay attention. You're having to spend time. You're, in fact, possibly manufacturing the wrong parts if you don't pay close attention to that. That's all handled for you now in Solid Edge ST8. If you reorder the list, it automatically renumbers your notes for you. Another very big enhancement in the area of drawings in ST8 is the ability to compare drawings. So we, in fact, have some customers who are upgrading to ST8 just for this one thing. So you could have drawing A and drawing B, and they're the same part, but you've done some revision, and like many people, you can't remember exactly what it was and how do these differ. Well, you bring that into the compare drawing tool and you have synchronized view where you have drawing A, drawing A1. You're comparing those side by side with synchronized zooming. It's also showing all the differences between the two, so you can easily identify whether the differences between two different versions or revisions.
Now, Dan?
Yes?
I mean, we talk a lot about drawings. We are the drawing guys, right? We have this mechanical drawing thing on lock. Mm-hmm. But there's a lot of different types of drawings that we need to interact with. You know, what about the more complex things? What about our ECAD drawings that we need to bring in so that we can communicate that over to our awesome new ST8 enhancements that you might see in just a minute? But things of that nature, you know, is there a way to actually handle that communication?
Well, it's funny you should ask that because there's an app for that.
Ah.
And to introduce that app, I'd like to invite John Malloy onto stage. John, please join me. Thank you.
Thank you, Dan. It's good to be here. And I'm John Malloy with Zukin, representing the E3 series. And Craig, you're having an issue with your questions to the audience because they just don't seem to be responding to you. So I think I can help you solve that. How many electrical engineers do we have in the audience? Oh, there's actually a couple. Well, that's good because you've got to be asking yourself, why in the world are we here with an electrical engineering product at Solid Edge University? Well, the reason is easy. It's called integration, okay? And why do we need integration? Because your products are becoming more complex, which is causing the electrical connectivity to get increasingly difficult. And as well, you're being asked to design within more space premiums and to putting more complex packages in smaller packages. So what all of this leads to is a requirement to actually try to model your electrical cables and harnesses in your 3D model. So how in the world are we going to take care of doing that? Well, There was a problem in the past. It's actually still a problem today. I've talked to a lot of you over in the center over next door, but the data sources that you have are a lot of times dumb. Now, we talked about Solid Edge actually creating intelligence out of dumb things, but if you're using AutoCAD or Visio or other dumb type of drawing tools, then you can't get the data out of your designs. You've got to actually manually enter any cable and harness information into Solid Edge to be able to route it. Well, that fortunately has changed. We actually now have intelligent electrical design tools that actually can automate that data extraction for you and take all of your cable and harness information and get it into your solid model. Our product that does that is called E3 Series, and it's from Zuken. Now, your next question is, well, who in the world is Zuken? Well, we're actually a global corporation. The good news here is then we can support your organizations around the world. We were founded in 1976. You may think we're a well-kept secret, but we are the longest-termed ECAD company in the history of EDA. We are only focused on ECAD tools, which is electrical CAD, which is why we make a good partner for Siemens Solid Edge PLM. Our CR5000 and 8000 series tools are our PCB products. If you're interested in doing some high-end PCB design and you need some new technology, then you can stop by our booth. We can talk to you about that. But what we're really here to talk about and what we've worked on the robot with is our E3 series technology. So let me give you a little idea of what that looks like. It's a standalone Windows-based platform. So it's not a plug-in. And your engineers, your electrical engineers, aren't used to using a product like Solid Edge. They're used to using their own 2D tools. They would like their own electrical engineering tool. That's the way this tool is designed. It creates schematics, it does panel layouts, it does wiring diagrams, and it also does cable and harness diagrams. So it doesn't matter if you're designing a full-on automobile, if you're designing a power generation plant, or maybe a small tractor. We have products for every one of those applications inside of the E3 series tool set. It's an object-based tool set, which is what differentiates itself from the dumb graphics. You're actually dealing with real parts inside of this program, and that way we can track every single component inside of those parts. And what that does is it reduces errors and it increases your productivity because you're not dealing with symbols wondering if the connection is proper. You're actually attaching wires into relays and getting your work done very productively and quickly. In addition to that, because of all of that tracking, we can track every single connection of every wire in that product, which allows us to be able to extract data. Now, we can extract bill of materials, put them into Team Center, or we can extract the information that we need to hand off to your mechanical engineers to be able to route those wires inside of Solid Edge. So let's talk about how we do that. The Solid Edge integration is based upon one of our products called the E3 3D Bridge. It's just referred to as our routing bridge. And what it does is it queries the product and it looks for every single wire, cable, or harness that's involved that you may want to actually import into Solid Edge and go ahead and route. You're actually able to select that, and you're going to see it up in the video here coming up in a second. And then we automatically generate the files that Solid Edge needs to natively read that information in so that you can use the Express Route technology inside of Solid Edge. So if we go ahead and roll the video, we'll see this actually happening real time. So this is the actual schematic of the robot. And again, thanks to Ross for allowing us to use that. You can see the connectivity here that's inside of the design. This is the schematic portion of the design. It's got all of the wires and the parts and the connectivity. Over on the right-hand side, you see the full component library, and those are actually truly real models of real parts. They're just not graphic symbols. So we're actually able to identify each of those. And then we can bring them up. You have a nice preview panel where you can see the part that you're going to drop in. And now we're looking at our real project. So those are the parts that are actually inside of this design. We just clicked onto the battery, and we're looking at the terminal connections on the battery, making sure that all of the wires are actually connected to the connection points, and we can see the different types of wires with all of the attribute data associated with it. So we can see the colors of the wires, the gauges, and you're able to put that type of documentation in there to any level. Now, this is the Siemens PLC. We also have attribute data inside of this. It's intelligent, and so when we create a bill of material automatically inside of this tool, it also includes all of the attribute data. One other cool feature, since it's Windows, is we can add hyperlinks here and bring in any other type of document type. Here's a PDF that we actually can click to, so you've got the programming manual for your PLC controller right there in your electrical diagram, and you can see it over there in the project. So now we're going to go ahead and show you actually how to add a couple of parts. The key things we're missing on this is the actual motors for the Armadillo. I like that name. So we're going to go ahead and add M1 and M2. So it actually pulls in those complete motors into the assembly. This is how easy it is to make connections in this tool. So the connections are done. Now the engineer gets to decide what kind of wire type do I want to go ahead and put there in the color. So he just simply pulls the wires right out of the library and is able to go ahead and attach those. So now our wiring is done. We're actually able to translate this assembly over into Solid Edge. So we're going to go ahead and choose our routing bridge. It's going to bring up a dialog box that's going to query the product and show us every single wire inside of that design. So we can select a few or we can select all of them, and in this case we select all of them and go ahead and let it know that where we want to output. And in just a second, what it's going to create is the actual component data and the connectivity list that Solid Edge needs to be able to import this wire harness and all of the individual wires over into Solid Edge. And then someone like Craig or any of your folk mechanical engineers can then go ahead and use Express Route to go ahead and route that. And there's the component. So that's as easy as it is. The electrical engineer is now no longer going to be the bottleneck. He can intelligently design very quickly as he moves forward, and he can get that information over to you so you can go ahead and route it in Solid Edge and have your product completed on time and with fewer mistakes. So thanks very much. We're over next door. If this is something that's interesting for your company, if you have battery powered or electrical, whatever, and you want to see the wiring technology that's now integrated in with the ST8, come pay us a visit. Thanks very much.
Thanks, John. Thank you, John. So that was great to see. That's another great example of partners in the Solid Edge ecosystem in a little different feel. That's a great example where it makes sense to have a purpose-built product for the 2D electrical task and a purpose-built product for the 3D solid modeling task in Solid Edge, and you had a really tight, close cooperation and partnership there. So in that vein, we've continued to enhance Solid Edge routing. The idea, of course, is that after John exports all his components and all the connectivity is there, we can create what's called a rat's nest that connects everything up in 3D. And then we've further enhanced the 3D routing capabilities, and we'll take a look at that here with Craig.
Okay, so in conjunction with that, John's created our components and connectors files, and we're going to show you some of the new enhancements inside of ST8 the entire way through, from import to routing, all the way through to nail board. So let's take a look. So we have our harness wizard. We have a prototype robot that we're putting together. We're trying a different version here. And the only thing that you need to do whenever you're importing is take a look at the document format. So we're going to use E3 series from Zukin, of course. And then we have our components and our connectors files available here to us. Of course, new to ST8, is now we have a lot of intelligence built into this dialog. So we want to be able to define which battery source we want this to. It says, hey, you got two batteries here. Which one do you want this particular wire to go to? All you have to do is simply select our currents, and we can do that for both of these batteries. And then in addition to that, it says, hey, you have two converters in the file. We only have information for one converter. Which one do you want to put it on? And you can very easily populate that as well. This is going to make sure that you get the proper results every time whenever you're going through an import experience. So once we click finish, it's automatically going to throw our rat's nest, as Dan was saying, into here, so we have our wires very quickly connected to the proper components. So So just kind of to switch gears a little bit, we finished one half of our wiring for our particular harness that we're working on. And I want to show you some of the new enhancements inside of ST8 with routing. We focused quite a bit on routing in ST8, and I actually got the joy and the honor of working with it inside of, throughout the development cycle. So I'm actually pretty excited about a lot of these things as well. So for those of you who are working inside of the wire harness environment, check this out. We have this new option available called Route. And guess what you can do? Simply select your path, select your cable, whatever you want to route, and then just click on any particular thing that you want, and it's automatically going to route that through. You can see here down at the bottom, it's kind of funky. It's coming in the wrong direction. All you got to do is hit the F key. It's going to flip that automatically for you. Make sure you get the proper result the first time through. Of course, for this one, we need to go ahead and finish up our route just to make sure that everything is right for our main trunk here, for our main base. And you can see how quickly we were able to take that and reroute that exactly how we want it going through those connectors or through those clips. So a great, great new command inside of Solid Edge ST8. Now, we also have a new option for split path. We want to be able to bundle these wires together. And for the last portion of our routing, we want to connect our motor to our component here. So we need to split the path so that whenever we do get ready to route the actual part or to route the actual cable, it's going to be able to have a split path area to go into. You can see new to ST8, we have a great new visualization of being able to see where those paths are split so that you can access them with that spherical object there. And the next thing we're going to do is just take a look at how we're going to route these paths. So Solid Edge has some pretty fantastic capability when it comes to being able to work. Let's just move this guy out of the way. When it comes to being able to work inside of a 3D routing environment. So anytime you're inside of a planar view, you'll notice that it's going to automatically stay inside of that plane whenever you're doing any sketching. So if I wanted to go ahead and quickly get some geometry on screen for these two paths that I'm creating, I stay in one planar view, and it's going to stay in that two-dimension area for it. And then all I need to do at that point is go back and use some of the 3D capabilities and finish up my route. So I'm going to do it for the first one, and then we'll just finish up this second guy quickly. So that you can see, as we finish up our wire paths, we're going to have a nice sweeping path to be able to route our cables through very quickly, very simply. And now, of course, the final part is just connecting the wires themselves. Now, I saved the best for last for this, because what I really want to show you guys is we've got some great new enhancements inside of Solid Edge ST8 to be able to visualize and to be able to complete your routing. So if you'll look up at the bar up here, we have a new command called Show Connector Information. Perhaps you didn't define this particular component, you didn't define this connector. It's easy as clicking on that, it's going to show you which terminals are associated to what, depending on what naming conventions you use for your company. And additionally, we have this fantastic new option called Assigned Terminals. So previous to having assigned terminals, of course, Solid Edge is going to pick up your key points depending on what your key point locate is. You know, sometimes it was a little bit difficult to figure out exactly what you wanted to pick up. However, whenever you click assigned terminals, it's only going to pick up those terminals that have previously been assigned for that component. And once again, just easily flip that around so that we get it in the proper location. And it just makes selection and key point locate so much easier to work through. Here, actually, just to kind of drive this point home, check this out, guys. Look how far out we are zoomed here. All we need to do is go to the assigned terminals. It's automatically going to pick up those key points for us so that we can very quickly and very easily get this guy done exactly how we want it. You don't have to worry about where you're going to click anymore. Now, once we have those wires finished out, of course, the final aspect of this is just going to go ahead and complete the bundle. So you select wires and then the path that we want to bundle through. It's automatically going to complete that route for us. You want to know the best part about this? Whenever we create our physical conductors, check this out. It's automatically going to calculate the sizes of your bundle based on the number of wires you have going through and the cross-section diameters of those wires. So you're going to get a very realistic representation inside of Solid Edge, inside of this routing capability, to be able to show you exactly what's going to happen out the backside. And of course, then you take this directly into Nailboard, you have the same representation, you have the same capability as far as being able to call out any kind of splicing, any kind of bundling enhancements, things of that nature, and then just round trip that back if you want to get your wire lengths, things of that nature, back into Zookin. So some great new enhancements in Solid Edge ST8 for wiring if you guys work with stuff like that. Dan?
Super. Thanks, Craig. So quite a lot of work in there. There's a lot of little pieces, the improving the ECAD integration, the split, the splicing, all those kind of things. I would say the big point, though, for a lot of this audience is wiring in 3D is kind of like the final frontier. You've been making great strides in productivity by creating 3D digital assets with your mechanical designs. You've maybe starting to work with animation and figuring out forces and simulation and so on. We still find a lot of customers out there who haven't taken that step to do the wiring piece. And the wiring piece can reduce your ECO count in that area very dramatically because it has all the same benefits you have in 3D mechanical you get in 3D wiring. So I'd really encourage you to take a look at the wire harness product in Solid Edge. Okay, other products in the ecosystem that people are bringing together and using very effectively. So CAM Express is really, I will say, the most complete CAM system on the planet. I will just say that. Continue to enhance that, though. And in fact, in the most recent release of CAM Express, it supports the ability to read the PMI from Solid Edge. So let's suppose, for example, you have a hole, and you've toleranced that hole in some way. You've said, I've got a dimension on it, it's this diameter, it has this tolerance. That information will flow through a JT file to CAM Express. It can read that information and do feature-based machining, making a decision whether to just drill it or bore it or ream it or whatever it might be. So that kind of intelligence can be brought into the process. We also have the in-window integration into Solid Edge of CamWorks, which now includes the WYSIWYG G-code machining and also quite a bit of work on the TechDB and so on. If we talk about solutions for design management, a couple different solutions to choose from. So design management based on SharePoint with Solid Edge for SharePoint, now supporting the latest release of SharePoint. And we've continued to build out that product. As you see, it has a very visual UI for seeing your product structures. We've continued to work on that and enhance that. Additionally, Solid Edge has a great integration into Teamcenter, world's most popular PDM and data management product. And so we've enhanced that in several different ways. Firstly, there's a new client for Teamcenter that's very modern and usable called the Active Workspace. Solid Edge is now compatible with that, so you can browse in the Active Workspace for data and automatically launch Solid Edge files. We've additionally worked on a variety of portions of the integration, but also made sure that it works for the types of releases you're on. So we go all the way back to Teamcenter 9 series, the Teamcenter 10 series, and now the latest Teamcenter 11, I think it's 11.2.something series as well. Okay, so a lot of power, a lot of unique power of Solid Edge. What about this accessibility thing? Well, we use that term accessibility in a couple different ways. The first is accessible to everyone. So what you find is that with smaller companies, not everybody has this $5,000, $6,000, $7,000 for a CAD seat. When you're in a small company, cash is king, and so you're trying to conserve your cash in any way possible. We now offer Solid Edge on subscription, and it starts as low as $100 a month here in the U.S. So that means you can get access to a whole new crowd of people who perhaps couldn't afford Solid Edge, or it just wasn't the right investment to make at that point in their journey. They can now afford that through the subscription, and we're seeing a lot of interest in that, and it continues to take off and grow. We also want to provide access to a wide variety of users who aren't CAD users per se, and we do that through our mobile viewers. You may be familiar with the fact that we have an Android mobile viewer and an Apple mobile viewer. We recently did a mobile viewer on the Surface device, and it's really our most complete implementation to date. It's a great experience, and it's available for you in the Microsoft App Store.
Hey, Dan, actually? Mm-hmm. While we're up here, I actually have it on screen, if we can show. How many of you guys out there have actually worked with the mobile viewer through your iOS, through your Android? Okay.
Wow, a lot of opportunity
there. You guys
really
got to get, come on, guys. We got to get with it on this. But it's a great way to be able to show your data, to be able to visualize what's going on, to be able to send it. Oh, no. Just ignore that last part. Okay, so it's a great way to be able to share your data. But it's also, we have developed specifically for the Microsoft app, for our viewer inside of the Microsoft DAC to improve it, to be able to create a lot of neat stuff to be able to work with inside of here. And actually, one of my favorite aspects of this, which you didn't see a couple of minutes ago, is the new enhancement inside of the mobile viewer, where you can actually use your device camera as your background for being able to take images. So hold your hands up here. Hold on to our armadillo. Come on, guys. Come on, everybody pick your hands up. There we go. And you can actually take images from it. You can do all kinds of different things. And there's just a lot of great functionality built into that app, especially if you want to be able to share that data. So,
yeah, definitely take advantage of that, as well as our other mobile apps as well. Go to anyone, the Google App Store, the Apple App Store, the Microsoft App Store. We have a variety of different platforms available. And I was a little, honestly, disappointed by how many people in the room raised their hand. You can literally download over the wireless internet right now to your device a viewer for Solid Edge, and a lot of people are doing that worldwide. Now, no discussion would be complete these days in our industry without talking about cloud in some way. I have a feeling that in our industry that the vendors talk about cloud a lot more than the users talk about cloud. And what a lot of people are saying is, well, I have this great new CAD app and it's in the cloud, but you can only have it in the cloud. Or I have a couple different products, one runs on-premise, one runs in cloud, and it's, to me, a very confusing strategy that says it's all about the vendors and not about you. And that is not our strategy. This is really all about you, our users, and what do you want to do. So what we've done is we put Solid Edge in the cloud. It runs the free trial in the US and the UK, so you can go out right now to the free trial site and say, I want to try Solid Edge in the cloud, and I invite you to do so. Tell us what your experience is. Tell us how that provides benefit to you. Tell us if that's something you want us to extend further. But it's really all about you and your decision. Do you want your CAD on your desktop? Do you want your CAD in the cloud? You make that decision and let us know.
Actually, you know what, Dan? Mm-hmm. We have the opportunity here. Let's just go ahead and show them. We're talking about accessibility here, mm-hmm. right? We're talking about working with the Microsoft Surface Pro 3. This is the definition of accessibility, being able to take your designs. Look at this. Being able to take your designs, have them fully worked with. We have the difference between the finger touch, the stylus. You can make selections, select your geometry however you want to. This is the true definition of being able to be accessible. And Dan also said a very important point there a minute ago. What was it? Anytime, any place, as long as you have an internet connection. Well, what about this? How about we change that for Solid Edge and say anytime, any place, doesn't really matter whether you have an internet connection or not. Solid Edge with the Surface Pro allows you to have all of this capability right at your fingertips without having to worry about, whether you're accessing the internet or anything like that. So just some incredible power located right here at your fingertips.
Yeah, thanks for reinforcing that, Craig. It's absolutely true that, if you really want anytime, anywhere, you've got to be able to pick it up and take it with you and not even have your wireless cafe connection. And you really get that on the Surface Pro. I'm excited. It's just a timing thing that the Surface Pro 4 and the Surface Book, of course, announced earlier this month, but started shipping, and I believe it was October 26th, yesterday. So kind of at the launch of Solid Edge University, those devices have started shipping. That personally is my next device. I'm getting one in 2 weeks. My laptop is gone. My iPad is gone. These are the two things. This is the one thing I'm going to use. I would take it a step farther than what Microsoft says. They say the tablet that's powerful enough to replace your laptop. I would say it's the tablet that's powerful enough to replace your workstation. And in fact, we have people in this room. In fact, Sean, who's come all the way from New Zealand, uses his Microsoft Surface Pro 3 as his exclusive device. He docks it, he works with it, and then he takes it with him on the road. It's really an amazing device, and literally Microsoft is not paying me to say this. It is the device I want to have, and it's the device I'm going to be using from here on out. It gives you full access to full-on Solid Edge. Take it anywhere with you.
Every demo you saw here today was done on the Surface Pro.
Yeah, so this has been, everything you've seen has been Surface Pro. There's been no workstation under the stage.
Yeah.
All right, so the last area I just want to touch on very briefly is amazing user experience. I can touch on it briefly because hopefully you've seen that already today in everything we've done, whether that's the Like Me patterning where it figures it all out for you, or it's the new Solid Edge heads-up design intent panel for Synchronous Technology. But we've also tried to enhance all the surrounding things. So if you're trying Solid Edge for the first time, you're downloading it, if you're downloading it, or if you're a subscription customer, as you do those installs, you're going to get a movie that explains the Solid Edge UI to you. This is very important because we have customers coming from other systems and they want to be able to understand how Solid Edge is different. We also continue to expand our learning portal. So Are you coming from a different system? Okay, we take you down one learning path. Have you ever used CAD before? No, I haven't. Take you down a different learning path. We've also tried to integrate some popular things into Solid Edge itself, the community where people go and ask questions and get those questions answered very quickly by often Sean in New Zealand or Tushar in India. All of the folks in there are very helpful, and I really guarantee you, if you go into the Solid Edge community right now and ask a question, you will within 5 minutes get an answer to that question about how to use Solid Edge more effectively. We've also added a Solid Edge news feed so you can keep track of all the things that are going on around the world in Solid Edge land. As John mentioned earlier this morning, and we have a great opportunity to highlight all our partners on stage today, or a few select partners on stage today, there is a new app marketplace. So how do you get a hold of this excellent technology? It's all found at plmappmarketplace.com/solidedge. If you go there, you're going to find a wide range of applications. You're going to find applications for as little as $100 that do things like make revision clouds. You're going to find applications multiple $1,000s that do piping and plant design. But the whole world is available to you there if you go and take a look. So then, just to bring things to a close, we've really talking about Solid Edge and designing without boundaries, and the three key tenets of that. Uniquely powerful with things like the like me patterning or the ability to leverage your designs and be able to do that design mock-up. Accessibility unleashed, whether that's providing Solid Edge and making that available to more people through subscription or through the mobile viewer, or whether that is using Solid Edge directly on your Surface Pro or Surface Book device and taking it with you out into the field. And then finally, all that wrapped up in an amazing user experience.
Actually, Dan, just before we go, one more quick note for everybody out there. If you'll show my screen, please. And I'm a little upset because Matt and Simon somewhat stole my thunder on this one, but I hope you've all been taking notes. See what I did there? I'll take it, whatever. So basically, for all of you social mediaites, for all of you tweeters, things of that nature, remember, we want to do hashtag SEU15. So make sure this is the tag that you use whenever you're tweeting about all this different stuff.
Super. Yeah, definitely. If you saw something you liked today, I definitely encourage you to get that information out. I also know there's a lot of press here. The press who are here, I encourage you to talk to our users. Find out what they're doing. Find out what they like about Solid Edge ST8 or their opinions of today. That's an awesome opportunity. One final question. Who here would like to see a sneak peek of ST9? Anyone? Okay, so that gets some hands up. That was a little bit of a tease because you can get a sneak peek of ST9, but we're going to do that at the wrap-up tomorrow afternoon. So Jeff Walker, who's the director of Solid Edge Products, is going to give us a little insight, not into like the biggest features, but some of the stuff we already have in the box ready to go. We've made a lot of progress on ST9, and so if you were thinking, I'm going to sneak out of here a little early, you can certainly do that, but you will not see the sneak peek of ST9. So hopefully look forward to that. All right, I appreciate all you coming. I do want to talk to all of you personally to the extent we can achieve that, and thanks very much.